Ever wondered how they make tomato ketchup? It all starts at the annual Tomatina Festival. 15 tons of tomatoes arrive in trucks, and the entire population of this small Spanish town have the most almighty tomato fight. Then all they do is scoop the stuff up, add a pinch of salt, and shove it into bottles. Yeah, right. Every year, we consume more than 150 million litres of tomato ketchup. And although there are over 50 delicious kinds of ketchup, there's a 50% chance that your favourite brand is Heinz. They began producing the magic red gloopy sauce in 1876. In short, they've had 130 years to perfect the stuff. So, how do they do it? The ancient Roman town of Elst, in the Netherlands. 95% of all the Heinz ketchup sold in Europe comes from this sleepy little town. It all starts with one of these foiled bags. Each bag contains 1,200 kilograms of tomato paste. But how do they turn plain crushed tomatoes into tomato ketchup? Remarkably, most people who work for Heinz haven't the slightest idea.
There's only 8 people in the world that know the recipe, and even I don't know the recipe.
Well, we can now reveal that the tomato paste is squeezed into large vats and mixed with vinegar, sugar and salt. Next, a man in white overalls with a hairnet picks up a blue plastic bag containing something and shakes whatever's inside into the vat. Then some men and women in white coats with no hairnets check that the contents of the blue plastic bags have had the desired effect. At 9 o'clock every morning, a sample from each batch produced the previous day is tasted by the Heinz taste specialists.
When you come in first thing in the morning and you taste ketchup before you have a cup of coffee, then people think it's very, very strange, but we're used to it.
But humans are weak. What happens if one of these ketchup connoisseurs is having an off day? At Heinz, there's no room for human error. So each batch of ketchup is also sent to the labs to test its chemical composition for acidity and saltiness. If a batch doesn't pass muster, it's rejected and binned. But there's one more bridge the ketchup must cross. In these health and safety conscious times, it was almost inevitable. Heinz has imposed a speed limit on its ketchup.
In 10 seconds, we can only have 10 centimeters flow of ketchup. That's the 10 centimeter rule. Well, this machine is what we call the quantifier, and it measures the thickness of the ketchup.
The velocity of ketchup is a huge worry. There's an ever-present danger that some unsuspecting customer will smack his sauce bottle too enthusiastically, inadvertently firing a dangerous dollop across the kitchen table.
Okay, here we go.
The arm is set at an angle to mimic the action of ketchup being poured from a bottle. And the Heinz scientists time the distance it takes to travel.
And it's perfect.
But what about the contents of those mysterious blue bags? Are the Heinz scientists among the 8 people alive who know the secret?
Yes, we know.
We know.
What's in the special recipe?
We can't tell you. It's a Heinz secret, I'm afraid.
It must be kept secret.
Finally, the ketchup is ready to go into the bottles. But what kind of bottles to use? It varies from country to country. These days at Heinz, there are 17 varieties of bottle and bottle size. The most popular is the newfangled plastic squeezy. But in countries like Germany, a more sober, traditional view prevails. There, the original glass bottle remains the ketchup container of choice. Only 8 hours after the tomato paste arrives at the factory, the finished ketchup leaves. Every day, almost 1 million bottles are shipped out to customers in Europe and Asia. But don't the tasters get fed up with eating neat ketchup all day?
We really love ketchup, yeah. We taste it every day, and we still, even after this, all these years, we still like ketchup, yes.
I would say me and my family, we eat about a bottle of ketchup of 0.5 kilo a week. It's what we call a heavy user.
And what about the contents of those blue bags? Sitting tantalizingly close on the other side of this door.
No, I'm coming here.
Only the 8 will ever know. Oh well.